If you're using SureCart, you've probably noticed something frustrating. While MailerLite and MailChimp integrate beautifully with WooCommerce with their fancy plugins, they don't play nice with SureCart at all. That means your email platform is completely blind to customer purchase history, lifetime value tracking, automatic buyer rewards, and identifying VIP customers. So today, I'm showing you how to fix that with a simple AutoKit workflow that tracks spending and automatically rewards customers when they hit milestones, like $50. No plugins, no code required. Let's get started. So from a very high level, this is the workflow that we're looking at. So let me zoom in here so we get to see. We start with the trigger, of course, is a purchase from SureCart. Then it goes over to Google Sheets and says, hey, add this order, this latest order, to our order list. Then we're gonna say, hey, are they already a customer? So that's our check here. Then we get into some yes, no branching. So if they already are a customer, follow this yes branch. If they aren't, we're just gonna add them to a new row in our customer list, and then we're gonna add them to a contact group, or the name of the group is called contact in MailerLite. If they are already on the customer list, fantastic. Let's check to see if they've spent over $50 lifetime. If they have, we follow this yes path. We're gonna check to see if they are in MailerLite, and if they are, then we're gonna check to see if they are a VIP or already in the VIP group. If they aren't already in the VIP group, hey, let's send them a coupon code because they've just crossed over our milestone of spending $50 at our store, and we wanna send them something special. So we're creating a coupon code, and then we're sending all of that stuff over to MailerLite, and then in the MailerLite side, we're sending out an automation when that customer hits the $50 or greater. So that's all that's doing at a very high level. Now let's get into some nuts and bolts here, and we'll see how I program this whole thing. So SureCart, again, purchase created. If we go into the select, you're going to need to have SureCart already installed on your WordPress website so that you can make this connection with AutoKit. And so that's what we've got going on here. The event, of course, is purchase created. Under the configuration tab, I'm selecting any product, but if you wanted to do this for a specific product, you could do that as well. And then, of course, we could test it out if we need to. Then I'm doing a couple of formatter options. One is so I can just obtain today's date, because the way it comes in from SureCart, it comes in Unix format or something like that. So I just wanted to get today's date so I could add it to our Google Sheet. And then the next formatter option is I'm dividing the total purchased by 100, because again, the way it comes in from SureCart is without decimals, and the number would be incorrect if I were to grab it the way it comes in from SureCart. So we're getting those two formatter options out of the way, and then we're adding everything, any purchase, to our Google Sheet. So let's take a look at that. Go under the Orders tab here, and again, we're just capturing every order: customer ID, email address, order ID, order date, and that's where our nice date comes in, and then the order total, and again, that's where our nice order total comes in, unlike where it comes in from SureCart, where you spent a dollar and it would actually come in as 100. So we want accurate numbers. Okay, let's go back to our workflow. And then we're doing a lookup customers. So if this yes, no branch here, they're kind of like combined. So we're looking up customers to see if they're already on the list. And what list is that? That's our customers list. So if we switch over to customers, we'll see here that we've had two customers visit, come to our store, and they've made a total of 9 orders. And what this is doing is just grabbing the customer ID, the email address associated with that customer, and the total orders in their lifetime with our store, the total spent lifetime in our store, the last order date, and the last order total. And again, we're doing the formatting here with the dollar sign. So this is our customer lifetime value tracker, okay? So if we go back here in our branch logic here, I'm just saying if the customer ID is equal to the customer ID, so what customer ID is that? If the customer ID that's in the SureCart store that was just ordered is equal to the customer ID that's in our customer list, then we've got a customer already. So that's a yes branch. If they aren't on our customer list, our lifetime customer list, this list right here, let's add them. So that's what the no branch is doing. We're going to add a new row, and then we're adding them to a group in MailerLite. So let's follow our yes path. Our next branch logic here is asking, have they spent over $50? So total spent, so we're grabbing our data from our customer list right here. We're grabbing this data here, total spent. If it is over $50, greater than is our operator, over $50, then we want them to get a special surprise. If it isn't, just make sure they're still in the contacts group. Now let's continue on with our list here. So we're fetching the data from our customer. So we're matching customer email from our customer list in our Google Sheet. We're saying, hey, find this person in MailerLite. And then what we're gonna get is all of their data right here. You can see here that they already are in the VIP in this instance. But if they aren't already in the VIP, this is our filter that we're checking. So we're checking that group name that came in from MailerLite. The operator here is does not contain VIP. Then send them a special surprise. So if it's true, it does not contain VIP, let's create that coupon. So in our SureCart call here, we're just calling our coupon name, $50 spent on store. We're giving it a percentage discount, 20% off. We can show additional options here. I can limit it to a specific customer. So we're getting the customer ID. So they'll have to log in order to use this. And I think that's it for that. And then we're gonna add all of this data over to MailerLite. So let's take a look at that. So we're adding them to the VIP group. We're grabbing their customer information, their email address. And you'll see here, I've got a couple of custom fields here. One is called sample products. So that's, I'm just grabbing the last product they ordered. So, and then I'm grabbing the store coupon code because we're gonna put that in our automation email. And I'm also grabbing the total amount spent. So I can track it on the MailerLite side. So I can do more follow-ups, more rewards on the MailerLite side. So let's say total amount spent gets to $500, I can send them something else. So I can track that on the MailerLite side as well. And so we'd have to create those custom fields in MailerLite first, and then you can map the data that you're getting in your workflow. So let's go over to MailerLite and take a look at that. First, we'll go under the subscribers tab, and under the subscribers tab is where you add in your custom fields. So you'll see here, I've got total amount spent right here. Here's our store coupon code. And I've also got the sample product right there. And if you want to create a custom field, you just need to click on create field up here, give it a name and select your input type. And just be careful of your input type because it has to match. So and for instance, under total amount spent, I have it type as number versus text, okay? And then you could also under subscribers do segmentation. So I've already got VIP store customers. I've got one in there because that's one person that's gone over $50. So if we click on view segment, you can see here I have groups belongs to VIP and that's our segment and we have one person in there. Okay, so that's how you do segmentation. That's how you do the custom fields. Let's look at the automation real quick. Here is our VIP store coupon. And if we just turn that off, we'll pause it and we can click on edit so we could take a closer look at things. Our trigger, of course, is when they join the group, VIP. And if we click on our email here, click on edit content, you can see here that I've just added a GIF, very simple GIF, saying, hey, you're one of our top customers and we want to say thanks. And I've inserted the custom variable, the custom field that I created that contains the coupon code. And then we have a link down here to go shopping. So a link right off to our store. And then when you're all set with your automation setup, click on done editing. And down the bottom, click on save and then turn it on and then click on save and close. So that's your automations, your custom fields and your segmentations all done in MailerLite. Now, if you really want to get extensive with this, I've done another addition to this, if you will. So if we go over to this one, this workflow I've created and it's all virtually the same except for this last piece here, I put in another yes-no branch. This yes-no branch is checking if their total value spent is over $200. And if it is over $200, we're doing the same thing. We're fetching. We're seeing if they are already in a VIP status. And if they are, we are going to send them a lovely postcard courtesy of LOB, L-O-B, L-O-B postcard, is something I found in the apps connections in AutoKit, which is really cool. So you can send off a postcard, direct mail. You can design your postcard in LOB. It's not a promo for LOB. I just happened to find them in there, and I thought it was a pretty good thing to do on the next level of things. So you could do $500 and send them a postcard with a coupon code, or hey, saying thank you so much, really appreciate it, whatever you want to say. But it's nice to have that little extra piece in there. And then you could build on this workflow and make it more extensive and give out more rewards and check for other things. So this is just very basic setup that I think you can do. And that's how you turn SureCart into a customer loyalty machine with MailerLite and AutoKit. Now, here's my challenge for you. What's the first automated reward you're going to set up? A discount at $50, free shipping at $100, VIP status at $200? Drop your answers in the comments below. I do read every single one and often reply with specific tips for your business. And if this saved you hours of manual work, smash that like button so more SureCart users can find this solution. If you want the complete workflow recipe so you can set this up in the next 30 minutes, I've got a step-by-step guide waiting for you in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.